Right, one, two, three, go.
Today, Alex and I will present to you our magazine for youth culture. We've called it The Future because
we're talking about how, like, young and, like,
they can have, like, a bright future.
Yeah, bright future. That's
do you find that neither end?
Our slogan is, like, the future bright.
This is our magazine cover. You can see that we named it as Youth Culture. We wanted to be involved in youth culture. We wanted to know what the youth is up to right now, because at this generation, it's really unclear what the people, the younger generation, can do. Because who's that?
The younger generation.
Oh yeah, the younger generation. People are passing, you know, every year roughly around, you know, 30 young generations. Young generations are young adults are passing away, and we wanted to show these younger generation that there's more than just in gang lives. There's people that are, you know, that made it out in the rough areas in the neighborhood. Like, for example, the local store, Tune Wayne, he made it out from the struggles. You know, he lost some of the friends, but that didn't keep him back from reaching his dreams.
Are you going to interview him for your magazine?
We tried to contact his manager, but we didn't get a reply.
The idea for the magazine was that he's basically screaming everyone. But yeah, our idea is like to, like, try to sway the youngest to, like, them, like, that. That's more than, like, being involved in gangs and drugs and those type of stuff. Like, you might see in, like, some music nowadays that popular singers might sing, but it's also the singers that like you said, they come out of the struggle and they, like, try to help
inspire the younger generation.
Yeah, inspire them to not do them stuff. And instead of, like, corrupt them, saying in that way.
So instead of getting illegal money,
they get,
you can,
like,
get legal
money. Yeah.
Instead of working illegally, you can work legal. So, like, they can look up to these rappers and, like, they can look at themselves, be like, you know, I can do that as well.
Yeah. Like,
as they say, like, there's better rappers than, like, Tupac. Why not you?
Yeah.
So the purpose of our production. The purpose of production is to get involved in that, what the youth generation is doing. We wanted to make sure that, you know, we wanted to interview some upcoming, you know, rappers or actors from the local area, and we wanted to make sure that we could inspire other younger people not to just join the gangs and, like, you know, murder each other. So that's not really a good thing to do, and they can face a lifetime in prison for that. So if they see, you know, these people coming out from where they're from, so the struggles, so basically the hood area. So if they come out from that, that means that they can do the same thing. Yeah, next slide, please.
The location, yeah. Most of the photos we've taken is, like, around Edmonton and that. So, and we just, like, we're local, and that's why we have most of the photos that you see next to that convention.
And the props that we'll need are obviously a camera, clothes. We didn't want any makeup because we wanted to take pictures of the people that were already in streets, you know, like in
the
fashion
yeah,
streets.
Like the real, like, how they watch it look.
How
they
actually, not like how
yeah.
the media presents them by. You know, people present them by just wearing, like, track suits, full hoodies, going out our areas, acting immature.
Hiding their face, you know.
Hiding their stuff with their hoodies, wearing masks, or, you know, yeah. Next slide, please.
The cost, like, we spend nothing really close, like, everything we use, but we already had it, so it's because we're sure.
So why would it be successful? So one of the main features is that it sticks out to our target audience, which is the younger generation, or teenagers, as they say, or young adults. So, you know, we're all about the, you know, the culture of the youth. So we want to make sure what the younger generation are up to. We want to, you know, sometime, you know, interview them or like see how they came up from this rough environment to like a really like a safe environment.
Yeah, and also like not make it like boring for them, like make it, because we're young as well, we can like interact with them and like do fun stuff, not like other type of meetings like they will just ask questions that might not like, questions that might not be relevant to them as well. So yeah, we'll like be interacting with them as well, so that's why we think we'll success them.
Some people, you know, when they're doing a magazine or like a video or interview or a video documentary, they will say, you know, they just do it for the money to get their story and sell it out for them.
Yeah.
But we're not really culture watchers here. We just want to, you know, make the younger audience, you know, stand out, and they're not really just about, you know, just gangs and like murdering people. So we just wanted to show them that anything is possible once you put your right mindset to it. So these are the pictures that we have taken, you know, to choose in our magazine cover, but we chose the image that we put in the magazine.
Yeah.
So we're going to be explaining where we took these and, you know, the days and so on. So
this one was taken for Halloween. It was at Jubilee Park, and it was just like to see like how do they celebrate like those type of parties or whatever.
So in this picture, you might see it's a dark place, and you might think that, oh, these people are, you know, they're dangerous and they can, you know, really harm you. Like, how did you take the picture? Well, if you really think about it, you know, you basically just judge the book by its cover. In this picture right here, we took it in Pauli in A10. They played football till, you know, legit like 9 o'clock or something like that, and you know they just wanted to take a picture and remind themselves, you know, how like they really care about they had the passion for football and they really loved it.
Instead of doing something,
using drugs, selling them, killing each other, you know, they like to spend most of their time just playing football, and that releases their stress and releases what their mindset have on other things. So like, if they had like family issues when they play football,
they might forget about it.
If one of their friends died or like family member, you know, when they play the sport, they forget about it.
That picture was taken for Christmas, and it was taken at a house, and like you can see how like they just like not they might be like dressed like.
They might dress as like a typical,
yeah, it's
know,
just like
typical casual gangsters.
Yeah, it's gangsters, but like, it's just like, most people, you see them from in the street, yeah, and they might like,
get scared, you know, scared of them,
but you see that they're normal people and that they just live their life and like, that's it.
If you really think about it, London's fashion for the younger generation is just tracksuits. And like, you know, sometimes trousers, but mainly it's just track suits and like hoodies and tops.
So you're trying to challenge the stereotypical representation of young people. That's good.
Suits, like, Next slide, please. Oh yeah. So we want to show you a video that happened in front of my house, where people got murdered. How I reacted to it.
The five boys who've been questioned are all aged 13 and 14 years old. The search for clues led by forensic teams. It's focusing on the entrance area where the victim first met the teenagers. The 52-year-old man was going into the flats when a row began with the group. They wanted to go to a party in the same building. Two of them followed the man inside and stabbed him to death.
So this happened right in front of my door, which I felt really scared, because I felt like, you know, I met the guy in the morning, you know, when I was going to school, and you know, he was a really welcoming guy, and he helped me with a lot of stuff as well when I was going through. And you know, seeing these, you know, things happening in front of my house, it should get you scared, and it should make you think about, you know, do they really fit the stereotypes? But so at the time, they probably were, the teenagers were probably drunk. That's my opinion, because they wouldn't randomly just stab a 52-year-old man for no reason. So we just want to make sure that, you know, it's not about like the how they are, how they're brought up. Maybe there were things like, came up with like another gang members and they told them to do this, or like, you won't be in it or we'll harm you. So, you know, it's really tough. Like, they should just, you know, just look up to the bright side and just, you know, proceed to their dreams, what they want to do. They can be a rapper, making music, they can be actors, you know, they can be a scientist, a lawyer, so on.
Whatever they want to be.
Where they want to be, they can go chase it. They just have to put the right mindset to it.
So are you going to have links, hyperlinks on your website, on your e-magazine, to places where they can get on apprenticeships and find these jobs and courses?
Just make it out, like, they don't have to just always, you know, go in gangs and, like, you know, they say it's easy money, which is easy money. It's quick. But, you know, why earn
it's
it?
It's risky because, like,
you can get caught by the police.
Yeah, it's a big price.
And you can't trust people that you're in a gang with. They're not really your friends. They say your friends, they're your brothers, but they're really not. Because one day they can set you up and, you know, that can be the end of your life.
Okay, good. Thank you. Lovely. Okay. No, I think that sounds really good. I like the fact that you're giving young people a positive outlook.
Yeah.
And I understand the fact why you've called it Future. I think that's really cool. All right, well done, boys. Thank you.